Hello again, this is Niels Myrner, and this is the fourth in a series of videos covering how to read rhythms for drummers, and we are working out of the book Syncopation, or Progressive Steps to Syncopation for the Modern Drummer by Ted Reed, and I would encourage you to pick up a copy of this book so that you can practice along at home. We won't be playing every single one of the exercises, we'll just be covering the techniques and the skills that you need to do so and to practice at home. So let's take a look at this. What we have in this lesson, we have triplets and quarter notes. So triplets are counted one e a. So number one here would be one e a, two, three, four. One e a, two, three, four, and so on. Number five, when you have two groups of triplets in a row, number five would be one e a, two e a, three, four. One e a, two e a, three, four. If you look up to number 10, a full line of triplets. Let's listen to what these sound like with a metronome before we dive into practicing the exercises. One, two, one, two, three, go. One e a, two e a, three e a, four e a. One e a, two e a, three e a, four e a. One e a, two e a, three e a, four e a. One e a, two e a, three e a, four e a. Three beats per click, or three beats per quarter note, triplets. So there are other counting systems. You could count them one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, or you could count them takita, 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 or one enda, two enda. Whichever counting system you may have learned already, you're welcome to use with these lessons. I'm just going to use the one e a two method because it's the first one I've learned, the one I'm most comfortable with. So let's dive in and try number one. One quick recap. Remember, if you're practicing these on a snare drum, you want to alternate hands. You want to count out loud and make sure that you're practicing them with a metronome. I have my metronome set at 70 beats per minute. And let's give number one a shot. One, two, one, two, three, go. One, e, a, two, three, four. 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 Good. Just a quick reminder, these videos are in HD, so if you need to be able to see the notes more clearly, make sure you have HD turned on YouTube and you're watching at the highest resolution. Let's give number two a shot. One, two, one, two, three, go. One, two, e, a, three, four. 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 Number three, one, two, one, two, three, go. One, two, three, e, a, four. 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 Now let's jump ahead a little bit to number six. One, two, one, two, three, go. One, two, e, a, three, e, a, four. 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 Okay, now let's jump ahead. So you'll practice those. Make sure the triplets are spread out evenly across the quarter note. One common mistake is to play them something like, say for example, number one, one e a, two, three, four. That's actually a different rhythm that we're going to cover later. So make sure you have the triplets spread out. A good test would be to play number 10 because you'll be able to tell if you're playing at a steady rate, then you'll be playing triplets. So let's do number 10 together. One, two, one, two, three, go. 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a. Good, now let's jump ahead to the 16 bar exercise and practice that together. I would encourage you to pause the video, play number 1 through 15 in a really methodical manner, counting out loud with the metronome, alternating hands, really trying to get them so they're just second nature, so that as you build on this foundation, it'll be very easy and it'll go really smoothly. So let's give the 16 bar exercise a shot when you're ready. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, 4 E, a 1, 2, 3 E, a 4, 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4, 1, 2 E, a 3, 4 E, a 1 E, a 2 E, a 3, 4 E, a 1 E, a 2, 3, 4 E, a 1 E, a 2, 3 E, a 4 E, a 1, 2 E, a 3, 4, 1 E, a 2, 3, 4, 1. 2 E, a 3 E, a 4, 1 E, a 2, 3 E, a 4, 1 E, a 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a 1, 2 E, a 3 E, a 4 E, a 1, 2, 3 E, a 4 E, a 1 E, a 2 E, a 3, 4, 1 E, a 2 E, a 3, 4. And one side note, you may want to make sure that you have watched the second of these lessons, because I talk about practice tips. Maybe you already know these things, but in case you don't, there are really two ways to practice these exercises. One is to work on your sight reading and your ability to play with a band, where you play the exercise with me from start to finish, and if you miss something, you just try to keep your place and jump back on with me, like jumping on a moving train. The other way is when you practice it by yourself, working out the difficult sections, you want to start with the hard parts and work on them by themselves, and then incorporate them with the sections surrounding them, and then eventually put them into the whole piece. So you're working on the piece from the inside out, hard parts out to the whole piece, instead of working on the piece from the beginning, always to the end, and wherever you mess up, stopping. Then what happens is you get really good at the beginning of the piece and not so good at the end. So make sure when you're practicing by yourself and working on the difficult sections with this or any piece of music, you start with the hard parts and then work your way out. And then when you're practicing your sight reading or playing with a band, you don't want to have to stop if you run into some difficulties, which everyone does from time to time. So you want to be able to play through your mistakes, but keep your place with the band. And that's what you would be practicing doing with me when you play the exercises along with me in the video. So I hope you find this helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to comment on the video or send me an email, and I'd be very happy to answer your questions. Good luck.